Hello, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Maida, and you're watching Maida Pours. Thank you so much for joining me today. If it's your first time here, well, you are very welcome. And if you're a returning viewer, well, welcome back, friend. It's so good to see you again. So for today's pour, I'm going to be doing something fun, something that I have been seeing a lot of people play with lately, and I had to give it a shot myself. These are, of course, marbles. I'm going to be doing a marble pour. I have my colors out here. I'm going to be layering these into a cup for a ring pour. I'm going to be pouring that first, and then I'm going to be playing with the marbles. That sounds funny, playing with my marbles. I do have a canvas here that is slightly, it is used. I painted over it in white. It's not too big. What size is that canvas? That's like a, I'll put it on the screen because I don't want to say it wrong. I'll put it on the screen and in my description what size canvas I'm working on, but it's not too large. I do have a mostly Liquitex Basics palette today. I've got Brilliant Blue right here. I've got Lime Green, Primary Blue, and Dioxazone Purple. I also have mixed up the Silver Extreme Sheen, which I use a lot of Extreme Sheen in my pearl pours, but I am going to be using this in my ring, kind of just like another color. Not sure what kind of effects it's going to create, if it, or any, or what it's going to do, so that'll be fun to find out. Always got to throw in, you know, like, oh, let's see what this does. I like being surprised when I pour. So, and I also have, this is actually a leftover from yesterday's pour. It's satin enamel, and I'm actually going to put this down as a pillow first before I pour my ring pour. Again, I don't know if it's going to cause effects, create effects. We're going to see. We're going to see what it does. I don't have much in there, so just for fun, I'm going to try it out. So let me go ahead. I got my cup right here. I am going to fill this pretty much to the top, but I'm not going to be using all of these paints. So I am going to go ahead and start. I'm just going to put a little bit of satin enamel at the bottom of the cup. Just, you know, for fun. All right. And I'm going to go ahead and do the darkest first, the dioxazine purple. And then I'm going to go with my brilliant blue. And then I'm going to go with my lime green. And then my primary blue. Time with the silver. With the silver there. And I've got about enough room to do, I think, like one more layer. I'm going to go in with just a little bit of white again. Dioxazine purple. Brilliant blue. Primary blue. Lime green. Some silver with some dioxazine purple. So that is one full cup right there. Always fun. I'm gonna go ahead and set this all to the side. We'll get the canvas out and we're gonna get to painting. Let's go. Okay, I'm gonna start by just pouring this satin enamel just right here in the center. We're just gonna call this, I don't know, like a mini cushion. I don't know what it's gonna do. I don't know if it's gonna do anything. Well, I know that it'll help whatever I pour on top of it kind of flow out. So that's one of the reasons I'm doing it, but I'm also just sort of doing it to see what it'll do. I did not have that much. I do have a little extra white here. This is not satin enamel. This is just some pre-mixed up Artist Loft Flow acrylic. I just wanna make my cushion a little bit bigger here. So I'm gonna pour that around and just make my cushion a little bit cushionier. Extra cushiony cushion. Okay. Actually never did that before. Used two separate different kinds of white, but that's okay. First time for everything. Okay. And I'm going to start by doing kind of just a simple, basic ring pour right in the center here. Simple, basic. I'm always so good at ring pours. I'm just gonna wiggle it. Wiggle it just a little bit. Jiggle it just a little bit. Okay, I'm gonna stop now or else I'll probably get like a copyright strike for for singing songs that are, I don't know how old that song is. How old is that song? Okay. I am not the best at making ring pours, but I can make really fun squiggly pours, so that's what. And this is going to be marbleized. Oh, I got that white in the center. This is going to get marbleized anyway. So catch that with my finger. That's an interesting center. Okay, I am going to go ahead and pop bubbles. And which marble should I start with? I have a big marble, medium marble, and a small marble. I guess you guys can't really tell me. I'm gonna assume you're telling me to use this big marble. Ooh, no. You know what? Let's go with the medium marble. Medium marble first, because, you know, like, I don't know what it's gonna do. I've never never done this before. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and just stretch it. I'm not gonna like stretch it all the way out. Ooh, it's pretty though. Pretty things are happening. And yeah, okay, we're just stretching that out. Not too much, okay. And I'm gonna set the marble right here, right to the side, and I'm just gonna let this sort of walk through and see what it does. We're gonna just, you know, kind of let the marble, the paint's moving with the marble. Okay. That was a swirl. Okay. This is very interesting. I'm so curious to see what it's like when I get it all stretched out. Okay, I'm gonna let that one like roll through the center again there. And then we're gonna just, yeah, we're gonna let it roll off the side. Set that to the side over there. And I am gonna go ahead and try the big marble as well. Same idea, I'm just gonna bring it in from the side. Ooh. Okay, that one creates quite a trail. Whoa! It's fun, it's always fun. I mean, wow, okay. Let's let that one. So it like kind of spread it out, but then it joined it back together. That's fun. Ooh, that's pretty. All right. That marble is pretty. I don't think I'm going to try the small marble because, I mean, I don't know how it, I mean, I guess I should try it, right? I guess I should see. Okay, let's just try it. We're just going to come over this side. Yeah, that one like is having a really hard time rolling through. We'll just come around this side here. Woo! Whoa! That almost flew off my canvas, but it didn't. Okay, I'm going to let that fall off there. All right. So I have a lot, I mean, whew, very fun here. I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna torch. I am gonna take some of my white paint here. I'm gonna get it up in the corners just so that, you know, I don't have to worry too much about getting those covered, because that's always the hardest thing to make sure you have covered. So this is just gonna, clump the paint in there. Okay, that's just gonna make sure that I don't really have to worry about my corners. Really wanna help this flow because I like it. And I'm just gonna pour this white around the center here just to really help it flow. Just to make it easy on the painting and on myself. Okay, so I'm gonna go up and over this corner here, up and over there. And I'm gonna bring it down over here, down to this corner, all the way over. Now it is time to stretch it on down the road here. Really get it stretched out. the marble had such fun and cool designs. It is a lot like a wrecked ring pour, I would say. That's what it reminds me of. We got that corner covered, and now we just gotta make it. The lime green is, well, it's very lime green. So if you enjoy lime green, you're enjoying this painting. And today I felt like very lime greeny, so I'm very much enjoying the lime green, which is why I broke it out. I mixed up these paints for this painting, and I mixed up another set of paints for another painting that I'm doing after this one, or planning on doing after this one, and they both feature heavily in like kind of a purpley blue greenish palette. The next one is gonna be, okay, much more true peacocky in nature. This one is only moderately peacock inspired. I just wanna get it all the way down over there, really stretch it out. I like the way things look stretched out. Uh-oh. I feel like I've got some lumps in my paint over here. Ooh, I'm getting some fun cells popping up over there. You know me, love getting fun cells. Yes, I definitely have a few lumps in this paint. A couple of big ones right there. Okay. So the other reason I'm gonna definitely stretch this out is because I see cells popping up and I'm gonna encourage them as best I can. And oh, it's pretty. It's fun. Okay. So I always do kind of a quick wipe around this bottom edge just to kind of make sure. I'm a very messy painter. I watch some brilliant painting friends on YouTube, and I'm always like, they are so neat and tidy when they paint. They just like keep their paint all scooped up. Everything looks so clean. Yeah, that's not how I roll. making a mess is part of the process for me, and I actually enjoy that part of the process. And this is such a fun painting. Loving these vibrant, bright greens, and I'm a little surprised at the I wasn't really expecting the cells. Okay, I'm gonna set this down. I'm gonna do some torching. And just trying to like, composition-wise, I think I might stretch it down over to this side just a little bit. Just a little bit. Okay. Okay. fun and pretty, and that marble, wow. I mean, like, how cool. I can see why everyone has been using marbles lately. It's so much fun, and it's like you're giving up a little bit of control, but you're also, I don't know how to explain it, it's like you're going on a ride. And it's fun. Okay, some cells popping up. Are they coming from my satin enamel, I guess, probably? Although I also threw down the Artist Loft Low Acrylic White, so I'm gonna assume satin enamel. I'm just gonna assume that. So I like this like, whoosh, and then this purple. It's just so flowy. Whew, everywhere there's flowiness. And I really like the silver. Although I wonder if the silver might be also what is pushing some of these cells out. I really don't know. I also don't know if it's gonna develop more. I wasn't really planning on it being a developing piece, so that remains to be seen, I suppose. So let's take a quick break. And we'll come back in about 15 minutes or so, and we'll see if anything else, you know, is going on. And then I will be bringing you in for a close-up. All right, see you in a sec. Okay, let's go in here and really show you what's going on close-up.
So if you enjoyed watching this video, well, please do hit that like button. It really helps out with the algorithm. And share this video if you share videos on your social media. Please do consider subscribing if you enjoy watching acrylic paint pouring videos. Well, this is what I do here. So be sure to subscribe and hit that bell notification so YouTube will tell you when I'm posting a new video. And be sure to check out the link in my description for my newly formed Facebook group page. I would love to see you over there and continue the conversation. Again, thank you so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. And I will see you guys next time. Bye-bye.